We are going to do a bit of badly drawn Bastille.
I love this account. They're great. Amazing.
It's good, isn't it? I've picked out some of my favourites, okay. And I'm going to ask you guys to tell us what picture it relates to, who's in it, what's going on, that sort of thing.
Okay.
Yeah?
Oh my God.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right.
So yeah. Here's the first badly drawn Bastille.
Wow.
That's when we met Yoda.
Remember? This is obviously a person.
I think that's me.
That's you, yeah.
What are you doing to that Yoda?
Oh, this is me.
Oh, that's baby lions.
That's me getting attacked by the lion, yeah.
Yeah, it's the baby lions.
There,
yeah.
Yes, oh. It's Woody getting attacked by the baby lion. Okay, here's the next badly drawn Bastille. What are we thinking? What's going on here? Who's this?
Oh, I know where that is. We were playing a show in Canada and we went for a walk and we ended up accidentally on a nudist beach.
How do I not know about this? Yes,
story?
It is.
Oh, wow.
Congratulations. So hold on, so where you're in Canada?
Yeah, we were playing in this arena in the university and went for a bit of a walk down to the like lake. And halfway down this incredibly long flight of stairs, we saw a sign saying it was a nudist beach. Because we'd already gone halfway down, we were like, oh, well, let's just see what happens. Got to the bottom. Turns out the only people that want to hang out on nudist beaches in that part of Canada are old dudes.
Isn't that the only people that want to hang out on nudist beaches anyway?
Yeah.
Did you think about getting your kit off?
No.
Okay, here comes the next one. What do you think?
Game of Thrones.
Correct?
Yeah.
Well done. Game of Thrones, when you guys were in Game of Thrones. So why are you in the outfits then? What's the situation?
We did a few like shows in Belfast, and that is one of the locations where Game of Thrones film. And so we kind of had a bit of like a relationship with them where they would come to our shows and they would take us around the set and stuff.
And Woody was like, extras? Extras, yeah. Come and be extras. But it was so much fun. They were so nice to us, considering we're a smear in the back of half a frame. It's very much so, if you pause and click frame by frame through it, you can see Carl for a split second.
This one?
yeah. I only post one picture a year, and it's of Will on his birthday. So if we're on tour, I'll take a picture of him myself, or I'll get him to send me one.
Will, I'm guessing this is the day after.
It's just every morning for me.
It's just every
how
morning.
I wake up.
Did you take that? Is that a selfie?
It's a selfie.
You...
Oh,
okay.
I don't know.
Oh, okay. No, this was a professional photo shoot.
Exactly.
Okay, next badly drawn Bastille. How about this one?
I've got my face on a balloon.
You looking at your old hair.
At your old hair.
Your new
hair.
And
you've just got your new hair.
Yes.
Et voila.
There you go.
I'd wanted to do it for ages and then we just chose to do it in a video. It's nice. Brilliant. I just have like a little rechargeable razor, do it over the sink every week. It's real classy.
Okay, the new album's called Doom Days. It's got a bit of an apocalyptic feel to it, gents. So we asked your fans to send in questions about how you guys would deal in an apocalypse situation.
Cool.
So you ready?
Ready. Mm-hmm.
I don't know how to handle myself in a normal situation.
Dan can't get himself dressed anymore, everyone. Millie from the UK is asking, what three things would you have in your Doom Days survival kit?
Curly Whirly.
Yeah, good energy source.
You're going to get hungry.
Mm. A pair of pants.
Yeah.
Because you're going to, once you've eaten.
Lipstick, because you never know who you're meeting.
Yeah.
It's a curly whirly. Pants and lipstick.
There we go.
Strong.
All eventualities.
We are sorted, yeah.
This is from Bernie in Australia. Bernie is asking, what would be your last meal before the apocalypse?
Pasty. Done.
What sort of pasty are we going for?
Traditional, mate. None of this, like, tikka lamb nonsense.
I'd relive the first meal I had when I left home. It was pot noodle and alpha bites, which is one of the best meals anyone
has ever had. That seems to leave a real effect on you.
So delicious.
Wow. Okay. Dad?
Like, an all-you-can-eat buffet that will never end, just to eke it off a little bit.
Yeah.
That's cheating.
That is cheating. That's like,
what do you wish for? Three more wishes.
Yeah. Wishes. No, no.
You got the pasty. He's got the pot noodle on alpha bites. And you got just like an all-you-can-eat buffet.
All-you-can-eat buffet.
You're welcome to have
this. Is this how the rider works out as well? Does Dan get the all-you-can-eat buffet and you guys are left with the pot noodle and curly whirlies?
Yeah.
Finally, this is from Ezra from the Netherlands. Hi, Ezra is asking, if Doom Days are coming in real life, who out of the four of you would survive the longest?
Me. I got a pilot's license.
Okay.
I used to do Kung Fu.
Yeah.
Which is embarrassing, but...
That's not embarrassing.
Practical, no.
Is it Kung Fu?
I think that's cool.
That was embarrassing.
Yeah, that was embarrassing.
That's all we did.
Yeah. That was the whole Kung Fu syllabus.